Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Sadaf. I review medical lectures. I take 2 minutes from you and save you from wasting a lot of time on a wrong lecture. Well, I'm a practicing hematologist and it gives me special privilege to review lectures on hematology. Today, I'm going to be reviewing lectures on hemoglobinopathies like sickle cell anemia and disorders of hemoglobin synthesis like thalassemia. Well, you see there is a slight amount of difference. Thalassemia isn't exactly a hemoglobinopathy. Well, I searched for 3 days and I wasn't at all satisfied, and I thought maybe I will have to do a good lecture for undergraduates. I thought that maybe the search engine of YouTube isn't doing justice to me. Maybe I need to search in many ways, different ways. But no, until today morning, I found an amazing lecture by Medicosis Perfectionalis, which was uploaded just yesterday. Wow, what luck. So once again, I will emphasize for alpha thalassemia, beta thalassemia, sickle cell trait, sickle cell disease, please do Medicosis Perfectionalis. I highly recommend it. I know you love Osmosis. There is sickle cell disease discussed by Osmosis. You have a need for speed, and so do I. But if you're doing Osmosis, make sure you do more details on crisis and the lab investigations. It's not enough even for undergraduates. Otherwise, it's a good lecture. So guys, there are basically 5 kinds of crisis in sickle cell anemia. Mnemonic being wash me with a V. So there is vaso-occlusive crisis, which has been explained. Aplastic crisis has been explained. There's a hemolytic crisis where there's a sudden hemolysis of RBCs and a drop in hemoglobin. There is a sequestration crisis where there is a lot of pooling of these defective RBCs within organs like spleen, and there isn't enough left for the rest of the body, and hence there is a shock-like symptom in the body. And then there is megaloblastic crisis, where the body is trying to form more and more RBCs, which are dying so quickly. So there is a shortage of folic acid and B12, and hence there's formation of megaloblastic anemia-like picture in the body. And if you're preparing for USMLE or NEET, you have to know some things about hemoglobin electrophoresis. There is Mr. Gobind Sparsh, who's talking about hemoglobin electrophoresis in sickle cell disease. He's giving you a very basic concept in a very easy way. Please do that. Also remember to know at least a line or two about HPLC as undergraduate students. If you want to do higher details of hemoglobin electrophoresis, there is Dr. Mungli. He's talking about it in sickle cell disease. Also remember that there are a lot of other sickling syndromes like hemoglobin SC, hemoglobin SD, hemoglobin S thalassemia. Don't get scared of that. Just know it. It's not for you. It's more for postgraduate students. You could just know it and skip it. For undergraduate students who want to know more about point mutation, autosomal recessive, and other such genetic elements of the topic, please see my review on genetics. That's all for my undergraduate students. Bye-bye. But if you're into research in these topics, you may need to do RFLP, RAPD, PCR, etc. You could use Shomu's biology. And if you're really studying hematology, believe me, none of these are for you. You need to do a lot of other protocols and a lot of other things which are not available online, at least in form of a video or a lecture. That's all for my review. Please like and subscribe if you find my reviews useful. Bye-bye.